Let's work through the following example together. Suppose a particle's position at time equals 1 is 7 meters. Its velocity at time equals 1 is 300 meters per second. Estimate the particle's position at time equals 1.03 seconds. Okay, so someone's firing particles very quickly, maybe in a physics lab or something, and we know a particle's position at time equals 1 and also its velocity. At that time, its velocity could be changing overall, but we do know what the velocity is at the point time equals 1. And we want to estimate the particle's position at a different point in time. And we're not given the specific position or velocity curves or formulas in this problem. So what can we do to estimate the particle's position at this certain point in time? Well, we can actually use the linear approximation formula we just learned to solve this problem. So let me write down the formula here, and then we'll figure out what all the different pieces should be. Okay, so this is our linear approximation formula. And remember that this formula gives us an approximation to f of x. Okay, so what are going to be the different pieces of this linear approximation formula for our specific problem? Well, let's think about what we know and what we don't know based on the problem. So what do we know? We know p of 1, the position at time 1. We know that's 7. We also know the velocity at time equals 1. Now, the velocity, remember, is the derivative of the position function. So this is p prime of 1. And I know that to be 300. So those are things I know. What do I want to know? Well, we want to approximate p of 1.03, which is the position at time equals 1.03. So hopefully you can kind of see how this might line up with our linear approximation formula. In our case, the function we're dealing with is the position function. And our a, which is the value we know about, is 1. And our x, which is the value we want to approximate things at, is 1.03. So now that we know this, we can simply plug into our formula to complete the approximation. Okay, so let's see. Let's apply this notation, but to our specific variable. So here, our variable is t, right? So we'll call this L of t. And our function is position. So I'm going to write this as p of 1 plus p prime of 1 times t minus 1, right? So I've changed the variables a little bit just to account for the variables we're actually using. And so we want to know at t equals 1.03. Okay, so then the linear approximation at time equals 1.03 is p of 1 plus p prime of 1 times 1.03 minus 1. Okay, so what's p of 1? Well, that's 7. The position at time equals 1 is 7. P prime of 1 was 300, right? That was the velocity at time equals 1. And 1.03 minus 1 is simply 0.03. Okay, so we can actually calculate this and get a value for it. So let's do that together. So we've got 300 times 0.03, and then we add 7 to that, and we get 16. All right, so it looks like our approximation is going to be that the particle is at 16 meters, I believe, were the units we used. Yes, 16 meters. All right, so then 16 meters is our approximation of the particle's position at time equals 0.3 seconds. Sorry, 1.03 seconds.